Mihai's granddaughters liked to keep to themselves mostly. They were well behaved and possessed a sort of quiet elegance. From time to time, I'd catch myself looking at them, wondering what they were talking about. I'm sure everyone on the base did the same. They were such enthralling creatures. Every night, a crowd would gather around Mihai. They were the men tasked with guarding him in the air. Their jackets all bore the same patch, a relic from a nation that was long gone. Decades ago, during the Age of Expansion, the Kingdom of Erugia absorbed many countries. Theirs was one of them. Mihai asked them,
"Yet what is a nation? Can we actually see the physical lines that divide one from another?"
"People of my generation can no longer speak the language of our homeland. My grandparents always look sad when they see I have no idea what they're saying to me."
Mihai didn't say a word after that. His scarred face betrayed no emotion. He didn't get those scars from flying, though. Mihai was originally from Shalaji. His real name is Mihai Dimitru Margarita Corneliu Leopold Blanca Carol Aeon Ignatius Raphael Maria Nikitas A. Shalaji. When he was young, he was the heir to the Grand Duchy of Shalaji. Then, revolution broke out among his people. Mihai was betrayed by a close friend who pointed a gun at his face and pulled the trigger. The revolution was successful, but the new country that sprang from it was annexed by the expanding Kingdom of Erugia. The Erugian royal family allowed Mihai's family to retain their title and noble standing in the new kingdom. But Mihai surprised them all by signing up for the draft like an ordinary Erugian citizen. He was then accepted into the Air Force Academy by order of the king. Mihai soon became an ace pilot. When the royal family was ousted and Erugia became a republic, he continued his service for the new regime. Test sites soon flourished. One day, a classmate of Mihai's granddaughter visited. I noticed the rose emblem. She laughed like a princess, and I found out later she was indeed the daughter of Erugia's new ruler. She was the connection to the royal bloodline everyone was looking for, the one to restore the monarchy. This new princess was truly a godsend for the Erugian people. If Mihai's granddaughters were like the moon, she was like the sun, around which everything seemed to orbit. Her face was so expressive. It's no wonder the people of this war-torn country instantly felt at ease when they saw her speeches. They started singing. The pilots of the support plane smiled, even though they wished their nation were independent from hers. Angelic. I wonder how Mihai felt about all of this. It was my job to research his neurological data, after all. I wish I could figure him out. Whatever his feelings were about losing his homeland, he kept hidden, even from me.
Your mission is to atone for your crimes by attracting the enemy's attention. First, I want you to head from the base to the desert region of Roca Roja to the northwest. And then second, you will attack the large Erusian base there. We've been unable to verify that base's ability to deal with fighters. You will attack and provoke the enemy into revealing their AA strategy. Get them to fire at you as much as you can. That way, we can confirm where they're firing from. Then, it's a case of sending in a regular force to clean them out. For this mission, we prepared a frontline base that can be used for ammo replenishment and aircraft repairs. However, this is not for you guys. Only the regular force has permission to use it. Even if you run out of ammo, don't forget that you're just decoys. You stay out there as targets for the enemy.
Aircraft preparations complete. Stand by at the front.
Some welcome. All aircraft, spread out and attack.
We're clear to attack, right? I heard the regular forces were gonna clean things up.
It's just like before. We blow the shit out of everything.
Sharp as a tack, aren't you, Spare 8? Regular forces can reduce losses if you tenderize the base first. If you can't handle that, just fly and be a target.
Target.
You're on. Fly squadron out, Trigger.
How are we supposed to work without ammo? I'm heading back.
Nice try. This stuff isn't for you guys. Let's be honest here. The regulars like us aren't allowed to resupply. But in your heart, you want us to smash that base. Am I off? You're gonna wish this mission never ended.
Looks like Bad Dog's finally come around. The targets are all hiding in the rocks. It's too risky.
Bomber has taken off. That's for us. Take care of it.
Finally have a read on the targets. They're in one hell of a place. I'll take you from here.
That bomber's getting away. Chase it down like you mean it, morons. All enemy bombers destroyed. That should put a wrench in their plans.
Yeah, we'll just leave it for once.
Hostiles in your area are nearly wiped out. Get moving to a more crowded area. Try to catch some more lead.
I'm coming out to the plane.
You're giving me another shot? Must be my lucky day.
The enemy base is divided into three sections. You did nothing more than destroy just one of them. Why are you acting like some big shot, Count?
Haha, Trigger's the one who did most of the work.
Why are you so proud of that, Fullband?
A big deal whenever a new mission comes in. But it's just one after another. Like that was the plan all along or something. Battle doctrines. Something happens, they tell you what to do next. Osea has one. And Bubble says where and when pawns like us will die. You mean they already know the next strategy?
Hold up, hold up.
Let's make a bet. Whoever guesses the next strategy wins. You can get in on this too, Van Dog.
Maybe you guys need to cool your heads off in solitary.
Let me look into this doctrine thing.
Man, you're delusional.
Bribe is all you need to look into a terminal. It's amazing how many people write their password on a note by their desk. Gathering intel is all
Microphone out here, Trigger.
Box 2. Spare 15, target destroyed. Approaching at high speed, bearing 280. They're drones.
These must be the infamous drones.
They can dogfight without pilots? Heard about them on the news.
Machines are not replacing humans.
Calm down. They're just obstacles in your way. Don't forget your original mission.
It's bad enough just dealing with the surface, damn. This is Spare 11. Enemy base dead ahead. Damn it, we can't do this from the sky. We need ground troops.
Spare 11, just do your job.
Just give us a bomb big enough to blow the area.
Did the jailer know about the shitstorm he was sending us into? Penal units are just pawns.
That lie is so bitch.
Don't pretend like we deserve any better. Continue with the operation. Trigger destroyed the enemy facility while everyone else was sleeping.
The murderer's done it again.
We're gonna have to rethink the odds.
Engage with
missile. No missiles left. Trigger eliminated target.
If only I could bring a radio to lift my spirits.
Spare 15, dead another. That's three.
I'm finally finding my crew.
I want it back.
1 minute remaining.
Bandit in my sight.
Missile inbound, evade.
Breaking off.
Missile hit.
Bandit in the tunnel. They're taking off from inside.
Tunnel? You gotta be kidding.
Sustained and crazy. Nice job, Trigger. That's five. I've shut down six. Bullshit. You're still on two. Hey, are you sure your radar's working right?
The enemy can only approach us from certain angles, so cover them.
Operation is complete. Head back. The bastards who flew off are going to wish they were never born. You guys get a pass.
Damn right. I wouldn't be surprised if we're thrown in solitary too. Hey, who wants to bet who goes into solitary? That's what that gambling nutjob would say if he was still here.
Where's your sense of humor, guys? Your buddy's making a joke. Laugh already.
You lost planes, but the mission succeeded. However, some of you crossed the return line for supplies and for repairs. This will result in solitary. Take them.